वेलकम टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव पास्ड बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर एनजी पोपटवार, हेड एंड रिसर्च सुपरविजर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिशरी साइंस, डीएसएम कॉलेज जिंतूर डिस्ट परभणी महाराष्ट्र, अफिलिएटेड टू द यूनिवर्सिटी स्वामी रामानंद तीर्थ मराठवाड़ा यूनिवर्सिटी नांदेड। बॉयज, ड्यूरिंग लास्ट 9 months वी ऑल आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम द पेंडेमिक डिसीज, दैट इज कोरोना वायरस। Due to this disease, physically, our college periods not run down. So, I have taken periods of BSc, second year, fishery science, on PowerPoint presentation, and then these PPTs, videos uploaded on YouTube. Please, you can see carefully. Any problem, any difficulties, please ask anytime. And when physically college is to be running, we can take again all these levels we have seen, we have studied online. During last few periods, you have seen we have completed BSc second year, semester 3rd, paper 6th and paper 7th. To the third semester, paper 6th and paper 7th, these are to be newly effective from June 2020. Your syllabus is to be continued from June, and it is the new syllabus. Old syllabus is to be not for your study, but for your syllabus. Remember that. That's why in new syllabus CBCS second revised 2020, BSc second year semester 3rd comprises two papers, section A, paper 6th, fish disease management, section B, paper 7th, fish developmental biology, and this fish developmental biology paper 7th divided into 4 units, unit 1st, unit 2nd, unit 3rd and unit 4th. We have started the first unit today. In this first unit, first article of paper number 7th, fish developmental biology, the first point is the types of fishes based on reproduction. Types of fishes based on reproduction, which type of fishes these are to be occur, which type of fishes these are to be found depending upon the reproduction. This first point we have seen today of the paper 7th. Remember that we have seen the paper 7th. Yes? Types of fishes based on reproduction. Fish is the aquatic, cold-blooded, respire with the help of gills and swims with the help of fins. That animals are called as the fish. What is meant by fish? We have seen the definition of fish and fishery science. What is meant by fishery science? Yes, in first year. Now, in second year, we have seen the paper 6th. We have completed maximum syllabus. Then paper 7th, fish developmental biology, we have started the first point, unit 1st, types of fishes based on reproduction. Fish is the aquatic, cold blooded, respire with the help of gills and swims with the help of fins. That animals are called as fish or pisces, which is aquatic, living in water. That may be fresh water, that may be marine water, that may be brackish water. which is cold blooded, which do not change their body temperature according to the surrounding environment. Hence these are called as cold blooded. They do not generate heat inside the body. They can respire with the help of gills. Respiratory organ is the gills, and they can swim. They can move from one place to another place, from one water body to another water body with the help of fins. That animal, these are called as the fish. Fish is the aquatic animals found in the waters of inland waters and marine water. All over the water which is to present in these water, this animal, these are to be found, these fishes, these are to be occur. Like that of the other animals, fishes are also differentiated. Into various categories based on their reproduction. These fishes on Earth planet, near about 30,000 to 40,000 fish species, these are to be reported. And all these 30,000 to 40,000 fish species, these are to be categorized, these are to be divided, differentiated into different types, different criteria, according based on the criteria. What is the criteria? Based on the reproductions. Like other vertebrates, fishes usually reproduce. Sexually, and in a quite large number of them, spermatozoa and eggs are formed. Like other vertebrates, like other animals, fishes are also reproduced sexually. In a quite large number of them, spermatozoa and eggs are formed in separate individuals, and the gametes are expelled in the surrounding water where fertilization takes place. Means gamete formation, these are to be take place. Gamete formation which is to be occur in these animals, in separate animal, male gamete and female gamete, and then fertilization, these are to be takes place, and after the fertilization, animal become hatched, animal become developed. Although fishes are mostly dioecious or unisexual, fishes are mostly dioecious or unisexual. Sexes are separate, that is male fish and female fish, which is to be observed, which is to be seen. Yes, it is to be female, sexes are separate. Fertilization is nothing but the union of male gamete and female gamete outside the animal's body or inside the female's body is called as fertilization. What is meant by fertilization? Fertilization is nothing but the union of male gamete and female gamete. When these male gamete and female gamete, these are to be union, these are to be takes place. That union which is to be occur either inside the animal's female's body, or it is to be utilization or union, these are to be occur outside the female's body in surrounding medium. That is, fertilization is either external or fertilization to be either internal. It is to be either external or either internal fertilization, these are to be occur. And after the fertilization, eggs or the embryos, these are to be formed, develop, and from these embryos, new offsprings or young ones which is to produce, and that young ones again, these are to be look like that of the parents or the adults. All fish species found in all over the world can be differentiated into following three categories, like that of the most vertebrates, which is to be occur similar fashion. Three categories, these are to be reported, these are to be found. These three categories are oviparous, viviparous, and ovoviviparous, in which we have seen the first oviparous species or the oviparity. Fishes which lay the eggs. Simple definition. Fishes which lay the eggs according to the based on the reproduction, these are to be categorized into three different categories. One is the oviparous species, second is the viviparous species, and third is the ovoviviparous species. And oviparous condition is called as oviparity, viviparous condition is called as viviparity, and ovoviviparous condition is called as ovoviviparity. Fishes which lay their eggs, these fishes are called as the oviparous. What is the oviparous? Those animals, those fishes which lay the eggs, these are called as oviparous. Lakshya theva, andas, andi ghalnare, अंडीज घालणारे किंवा अंडज, दोज एनिमल्स, दोज फिशेस विच ले द एग्स, दीज फिशेस, दीज एनिमल आर कॉल्ड एज द ओवी प्यारस फिशेस, ओवी प्यारस एनिमल, दोज फिशेस विच स्पॉन आर ले देअर एग्स, ले देअर एग्स अराउंड द सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट, अराउंड इन द सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट, सराउंडिंग इकोसिस्टम, सच एनिमल्स, सच फिशेस आर कॉल्ड एज द ओवी प्यारस फिशेस, दोज फिशेस विच स्पॉन्स विच आर ले द एग्स अराउंड द सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट, दैट मे बी फ्रेश वाटर, दैट मे बी मरीन वाटर, सच फिशेस आर कॉल्ड एज द ओवी प्यारस फिशेस, सच फिशेस आर कॉल्ड एज ओवी प्यारस फिशेस, द एनिमल्स प्रोड्यूसिंग यंग वंस बाय मीन्स ऑफ एग विच आर हैच्ड आफ्टर दे हैव बीन लेड बाय द पेरेंट्स एंड सच कंडीशन इट इज टू बी कॉल्ड एज ओविपेरस एनिमल्स और फिशेज. अनदर डेफिनेशन ऑफ ओविपेरस फिशेज, द फिशेज आर द एनिमल्स प्रोड्यूसिंग यंग बाय मीन्स ऑफ एग्स, प्रोड्यूसिंग यंग बाय मीन्स ऑफ एग्स विच आर हैच्ड आफ्टर दे हैव बीन लेड बाय द पेरेंट्स, आफ्टर पेरेंट दे कैन ले द एग्स एंड फ्रॉम दिस एग ऑफस्प्रिंग दीज आर टू बी फॉर्म, यंग वन दीज आर टू प्रोड्यूस हैच्ड फ्रॉम दीज एग्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द ओविपेरस फिशेज, लाइक दैट ऑफ द बर्ड्स. आवर पॉपुलर बर्ड इज द हेन, इन एवरी वन्स होम हेन इज टू बी वी हैव कल्चर सिमिलर फैशन, दीज हेन्स दीज आर टू बी ले द एग्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द ओविपेरस एनिमल्स. सिमिलरली इन फिशेज ऑल्सो, दोज फिशेज विच ले द एग्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज ओविपेरस फिशेज, ओविपेरस एनिमल्स आर द एनिमल्स दैट ले देयर एग्स with little, with little or no other embryonic development. Any little embryonic development is to be occur, or sometime there is no embryonic development, these are to be occur within the mother's body, within the female's body, that animal is called as the oviparous animals or oviparous species. Another definition of oviparous animals or fishes, oviparous animals are the animals that lay their eggs with little or no other embryonic development within the mother's body, within the mother's body, that animals are called as oviparous animals or the oviparous fishes. Next, the animals or fishes that producing eggs, the animals or fishes that producing eggs and that develop the and hatch after leaving the body of females called as oviparous fishes. And those fishes are oviparous, such condition of oviparous fishes are called as oviparity. Egg laying capacity, egg laying conditions of the animals is called as oviparous, and such oviparous animal condition is called as oviparity. And in fishes, maximum number of fishes, these are the oviparous, or they can be oviparity, which is to be occur, which is to be found. Which are the examples of this oviparous fishes? Example such as chimera, example such as skates, chimera, skates, chimera is the animals from Holocephali, skates are the animals from Elasmobranchi, and majority of the bony fishes, majority of the bony fishes are the teleost fishes, is the examples of the oviparity or the oviparous fishes. This is the first according to or based on the reproduction. Those animals which lay the eggs, these are called as oviparous, and such condition is called as oviparity. And those fishes which lay the eggs, these fishes are called as oviparous, and that condition is called as oviparity. Oviparous fishes are the oviparity condition which is to be occur in fishes, for example in chimera, for example in skates, or in the majority of the bony fishes or the teleostomy members. Maximum teleostomy fishes are the oviparous, they lay their eggs surrounding water. This is the first criteria, first type of fishes based on the reproduction. Second type of fishes which is to be based on the reproduction, that is viviparous fishes and viviparity. Viviparous fishes and viviparity. The fishes which gives birth, remember viviparous, the fishes which gives birth to young ones, these are called as viviparous. लाइक दैट ऑफ द पेरेंट्स फिशेज गिव बर्थ टू द यंग वन सिमिलरली जसे इन बफेलो इन काऊ इन ह्यूमन बींग बफेलो काऊ इन ह्यूमन बींग दैट इज फीमेल गिव बर्थ टू द यंग वन्स टू सिमिलर टू देट टू देअर पेरेंट्स माता पिता सारखं त्यांच्या आई वडिलासारखाच ऑफस्प्रिंग किंवा बाळ जन्माला देणे बाळ जन्माला घालणे म्हणजेच काय विविपॅरस कंडिशन्स ऑफ विविपॅरस फिशेस दोज फिशेस विच गिव बर्थ टू द यंग वन्स दीज फिशेस आर कॉल्ड एज विविपॅरस फिशेस और दोज एनिमल्स आर फिशेस विच गिव डायरेक्ट बर्थ टू द यंग वन्स लाइक दैट ऑफ द पेरेंट विच गिव्स डायरेक्ट बर्थ टू द यंग वन्स लाइक दैट ऑफ द पेरेंट्स सच एनिमल्स और सच फिशेस आर कॉल्ड एज विविपॅरस फिशेस द विविपॅरस फिशेस मे बी ऑफ प्लासेंटल और इट मे बी ऑफ अप्लासेंटल टाइप्स प्लासेंटल और इट मे बी अप्लासेंटल प्लासेंटा दैट इज कनेक्शन बिटवीन मदर एंड कनेक्शन बिटवीन द फिटस और एम्ब्रियो दैट कनेक्शन दैट लिंकेज इज कॉल्ड एज द प्लासेंटा दैट मे बी प्लासेंटल और दैट मे बी अप्लासेंटल टाइप ऑफ फिशेस दीज आर टू बी ऑकर फाउंड इन फिशेस अमंग द फिशेस ओनली इन द फिशेस और अमंग द फिशेस ओनली इलियास्मोब्रांक एंड सम ऑफ द टिलियोस ओनली इलियास्मोब्रांक्स एंड सम ऑफ द टिलियोस हैव अचीव्ड ए ट्रू विविपॅरिटी अचीव्ड ए ट्रू विविपॅरिटी इन दीज केसेस द यॉक कंटेंट ऑफ एग्स इन दीज केसेस द यॉक कंटेंट ऑफ एग इज ग्रेटली रिड्यूस्ड एंड द डेवलपिंग यंग वन्स एस्टैब्लिश ए कनेक्शन्स विद द मैटरनल टिश्यू एट एन अर्ली स्टेज टू ड्रॉ द न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम पेरेंट न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम मदर सच कंडीशन सच सिचुएशन दीज आर टू बी ऑकरिंग विविपॅरस फिशेस वॉट इज द कंडीशन अमंग द फिशेस ओनली इन इलियास्मोब्रांकाइंड एंड सम टिलियोस सम इलियास्मोब्रांकाइंड सम टिलियोस्टोमी मेंबर बोनी फिशेस हैव अचीव्ड ए ट्रू विविपॅरिटी इन दीज केसेस द यॉक कंटेंट विच इज टू प्रेजेंट इन एग इज ग्रेटली रिड्यूस्ड एंड द डेवलपिंग यंग वन्स एस्टैब्लिश ड्यू टू द एब्सेंस ऑफ यॉक द डेवलपिंग यंग वन्स डेवलपिंग एम्ब्रियो एस्टैब्लिश ए कनेक्शन विथ इट्स मदर विथ इट्स मैटरनल टिश्यू एट एन अर्ली स्टेज टू टेक न्यूट्रिशन टू टेक द रिक्वायर्ड मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम द मैटर मदर्स बॉडी फ्रॉम मैटरनल बॉडी हेन्स दे हैव ए डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कनेक्शन बिसाइड सैटिस्फाइंग देयर रेस्पिरेटरी एंड एक्सक्रिटरी डिमांड्स हाउएवर phenomenon of viviparity is quite different in elasmobranchi and just to be quite difference in the viviparous tilios means viviparity is the same those which give birth to the young ones it is called as viviparous but that may be placental type or that may be aplacental type placental type when embryos these are to be covered inside the or protect inside the placenta and this placenta these are to be provide that is respiratory and excretory demand of embryo it is called as a placenta and suppose embryo these are to be not covered a placenta that embryo is called as aplacental means in these fishes both placentalized and aplacental condition these are to be occur viviparous condition these are to be found besides satisfying their respiratory and excretory demand however phenomenon of viviparity is quite different in Elasmobranchs and it is to be quite different in viviparous teleost. The placental fishes includes various hammer-headed shark. Placental fishes includes various hammer-headed shark and grey shark. Number of shark which is to be hammer-headed shark that is Pristis and grey shark in these shark that is these shark placenta is to present and this placenta these are to be cover and provide the tissues or provide the required material for the mother's body. The embryos of these depend upon the yolk content of their eggs for a short while and later it derive the nourishment from the maternal tissue. Viviparous fishes are also known as live bearers manje pilanna janma denare to give birth to the young ones it is called as live bearers to give the birth to the young ones similar to the parents. That's why placental and aplacental fishes, these are to be found in this second criteria, second group. Fishes, these are to be divided based on the reproduction criteria second, depending upon whether it is to be give birth to the young ones or whether it is to be lay the eggs. Pahila andi denara. Dusra pilana janma denara. There is direct development or it is to be occur found. It is called as viviparous species, and such condition is to be called as viviparity. Such condition is called as viviparity. Example of this viviparous species or viviparity is some sharks, some teleosts, intellos, specially Cyprinodontiformis, and Perciformis order. These two order members, these are the viviparous, highly or truly these are the viviparous species. They give birth to the young ones. That is Cyprinodontiformis and the Perciformis members. It have live bearers similar to that of the tilapia, similar to that of the, that is Gambusia apinis. These fishes are chichilid fishes which give birth to the direct young ones. That is viviparous. Shark, like that of the shark. Which are the shark? That is the marine water shark. It is called as Squalidon or dogfish, which is the live bearers or viviparous fish we have seen in classification. Yes, that is the second criteria we have completed here. Then third criteria, oho viviparous species or oho viviparity. Oho viviparous species or oho viviparity. Combination of oviparous and combination of viviparous. And third criteria, these are to be formed. It is called as oho viviparous. Pahila kay pahila kutla pahila pan? Oviparous. Those lay the eggs. Fakta andi ghalnare andach. Second, that is oviparous first. Second, viviparous. Pinalna janmadaya to give birth to the young ones. Give birth to the direct young ones. It is called as viviparous. Pahila andi ghalnare. Dusra na pilana janmadaya. And tisra, different both combination of oviparous and combination of viviparous, it is called as oho viviparous species or the oho viviparity. Those animals or fishes which first lay their eggs, and then these eggs are hatched and nourished. First lay the eggs, then these eggs, these are to be hatched and nourished. Such animals or fishes, these are called as oho viviparous. What is the condition? What is the animals? First, these animals lay the eggs and these laid eggs, these are to be hatched and nourished. Pahile pilana andi ghaltat ani maghi andi kay kartat ubavtat, incubate kartat, hatched, and then it is to be nourished up to grown condition. Tumhi komdi pahili asel, hen pahili asel. Yes, जो पर्यंत पिल्लं मोठं होत नाही तोपर्यंत त्याची सांभाळ करते, पॅरेंटल केअर करते, काळजी करते. देन आफ्टर इट कॅन नो टेक केअर. सिमिलरली दे कॅन हॅच अँड नॉरिश सच ॲनिमल्स आर फिशेस, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द ओहो विविपॅरस फिशेस. द ओहो विविपॅरस फिशेस देट मे बी अ प्लासंटल स्पेसिस. दे कॅन नॉट बी स्ट्रिक्टली रिगार्डेड एज विविपॅरस अप्लासंटल स्पेसिस. ओहो विविपॅरस अप्लासंटल स्पेसिस. They cannot be strictly regarded as viviparous because their embryos either depend upon the yolk, deserve or receive nourishment by way of nutritive threads produced from the oviduct wall of their mothers, and hence called as oho viviparous. What is the condition? A placental species. They cannot be strictly regarded as viviparous because their embryos either depend upon yolk, which is to present in their embryo's body, or it is to be deserves or receives nourishment by the way of nutritive threads. Nutritive threads, these are to be appear produced from the oviduct wall of the mother's body, and this oviduct wall of the mother's body, oviduct these are, and this oviduct, these are to be provide connected to the one side mother and another side to the embryo, and this oviduct, it can provide the nutritive requirement for the offspring, for the young ones, and with this it can hatch, it can develop, and then it can nourish these eggs, these embryos. It is called as ovoviviparous condition. These are to be seen. The ovoviviparous species are much more numerous. The ovoviviparous species are much more numerous than the placental viviparous ones. In the ovoviviparity, though the fertilization is internal and the organic material is present in the uterus, has similar content, but it may vary from the viviparous ones, which has to provide protection but not the organic nutrient. That is, ovoviviparous species are much more numerous than the placental viviparous ones. Means placental viviparous species and ovoviviparous species, these are to be different, these are to be apart from one another, because in the ovoviviparity, though the fertilization is to be internal and organic material is present in the uterus, mother's, that is thread called as uterus, has a similar content, but it may vary from viviparous ones and ovoviviparous ones, which produce which provide the protection but not the organic nutrient. And such condition, these are to be found, it is called as ovoviviparous species or fishes. And when in those fishes, in those animals, or in those fishes, such ovoviviparous condition, these are to be found, it is called as ovoviviparity. And this ovoviviparity is nothing but the combination of oviparous and combination of vipar. Means this animal, these are to be not completely truly oviparous, nor it is to be a viviparous. Means in between these two, some characters of oviparous and some characters of viviparous, these are to be taken, and new variety, these are to be formed, new group, these are to be formed. It is called as ovoviviparous animals or ovoviviparous fishes. And example of this ovoviviparous fishes are the eagle ray, example these are the stingray, example these are the butterfly ray, etc. All these are the different examples of the third criteria, third category, that is ovoviviparous fishes. Means according to the reproduction, fishes which is to present in whole earth planet or in Indian region, these fishes are to be divided or categorized into three categories: oviparous, lay the eggs; viviparous, give birth direct to the young ones; and third, ovoviviparous, first lay the eggs, then these eggs are to be hatched, nourished, and after juvenile development it can be released. Such condition, it is to be called as the ovoviviparous condition. And with this, fishes, these are to be categorized, fishes, these are to be divided with these three types: oviparous, viviparous, and ovoviviparous, or oviparity, viviparity, or ovoviviparity. Up to here we have completed the first point, first article of fishes. Depending upon, based on criteria reproduction, fishes are categorized or divided into these three types. Up to here we have understand. Welcome, and again thank you all of you. Hope you are understand better. Suppose any problem, any difficulty, please ask anytime.